morning, friends. Let us look at the Elizabethan dramatists. We have studied the university wits and the early development of Elizabethan drama in our previous lectures. Let us look at another great dramatist. Apart from Shakespeare, the Elizabethan period witnessed a tremendous development, and the contribution of Ben Jonson, the dramatist, is worth considerable. Ben Jonson was a contemporary of Shakespeare and who imbibed all the tradition and culture of Elizabethan England. Ben Jonson departed from the traditional way of writing. The university wits who used horror, crime, ghost, supernatural elements, and even Shakespeare, the great Elizabethan dramatist, also followed the techniques of using supernatural elements in the plays, seem to end there. And Ben Jonson, who took a different path by thinking in a different way. Ben Jonson was a contemporary of Shakespeare who lived during the same heyday of Elizabethan literature, was a considerable contributor because of his different path that he followed. When we look at the Elizabethan drama, Ben Jonson's dramas are very significant in terms of the theme and technique that he used. Ben Jonson tried to coin a different idea and a term using comedy of humors in his plays. Ben Jonson called all his dramas as comedies of humor. When we look at the 17th century and 18th century, or the Restoration comedy, Restoration drama in England, we are familiar with the term comedy of manners. Comedy of manners tried to imitate the manners, habits, or the intricacies of human beings in the Restoration English society. Whereas Ben Jonson was different in previous age. Comedy of humors, according to Ben Jonson, means imitating or presenting one or the other weaknesses of the human beings that human beings commonly suffer due to the physical problems. Ben Jonson took four different aspects of human physiology, that is, the questions of phlegm, bile, cough, cold, etc., that causes variation in the physical condition of human beings. The excess or deficiency of any of these, whether it is phlegm, bile, cough, or cold, it leads to a difference in character and sometimes eccentric behavior in human beings. Ben Jonson called this variation in behavior, in emotion, as eccentric character, and he called them as humors. These physical differences caused by the excess or deficiency of cold, cough, bile, phlegm, etc., is called as a humor. Ben Jonson uses these elements in his plays. For example, his plays like Every Man in His Humor, Every Man Out of His Humor, Walpone, Alchemist, Silent Women are examples. In his play like Every Man in His Humor and Every Man Out of His Humor, he used either of these elements, either the extreme cold that one suffers, or extreme cough that undergoes, are the reasons of causing the two unwanted behavior in the human beings, either their anger or silence or timidity or dull, morose character are all caused by variation in these physical elements. If somebody suffers from cough or cold or by the phlegm, it will lead to an eccentric behavior. He called these as humors, and all these elements in the physical aspect of human beings is very common. Every human being suffers from one or the other of these elements, and how a shortage or excess of these will lead to a very dull character or very highly enthusiastic, vibrant character or very unemotional, dry character and suffering from chronic invalid, etc. These are the reasons that make really human beings suffer. Every man in his humor, every man out of his humor, or Walpole, alchemist, etc., make such characters come on the stage. The characters, whether it is a protagonist or secondary characters, who suffer from these problems will cause problem to the entire surrounding. Ben Jonson, through these elements, tried to live the day-to-day life or the very earthly life of the surroundings where he lived. All the characters in one or the other play happen to present these elements. This eccentricity of human being is a very common nature that so many human beings suffer. Ben Jonson, who didn't go to history or political aspect of the English society like Shakespeare, but happened to be on the very social aspect of life. These plays, even though seem to be less in number, are very powerful in their expression. His intellectual character is presented through these plays. Ben Jonson seemed to be a satirist, though intellectual, seemed to be satirist, but at the same time very realistic in nature. He is opposed to emotion and imagination. All these plays, though they are humorous and funny, happen to be very realistic and impartial. At the same time, they are not emotional or imaginative. They are real society that is presented through his plays. And the position of Ben Jonson as a dramatist in 16th century English literature is highly regarded, because he took a different path and tried to bring that humor, fun on the stage in a very vibrant manner, using these elements which are very common to human beings. Thus, the estimation of Ben Jonson as a dramatist is worth considerable in the history of Elizabethan drama. Thank you.